over here and push me.
Where, though? Into what?
What is it, dog?
You're not gonna get a lot of serious shit out of me, man.
This is all gonna be a bunch of beeps and poop jokes.
My name's Scott Underwood. And this is my crib empty.
You got some cheese right there! That's where I kicked in one toe! That's where I kicked in one toe!
Check out the view. Come on. This is where actually Charlie and I do a lot of writing. You'll notice you've got all the writing essentials. You got your keyboards, you got your coffee, your cigarettes. This is a Kurtz Weill. We've written, just a bunch. You're Every Color, Calling All Angels. I'm About to Come Alive, I think, had some action here. This is where all the magic happens. This is where the magic's supposed to happen. That's where all the magic happens. This room is supposed to be where the magic happens.
This is the backyard. This is where all the magic happens.
This is where all the magic happens.
This was the one major rock star move I made in my life, because I actually just was driving by the Porsche dealer, saw this, loved it. It's one of my favorites, you know, my favorite style and year and all that stuff. And wrote a check for it and drove it off the lot all within about an hour. It was weird, man. It was weird. I felt really nauseous afterwards. Kind of like, what did I just do? What did I do? I'm an asshole. I'm evil. I mean, there's starving people in the world. There's disease. There's war. And I go and write a f***ing check for a Porsche?
I like driving my Porsche over San Francisco's Golden Gate Bridge.
Man, you know, I like to joke around a lot. I don't take a lot of things too seriously.
I'm really happy to still be able to say, after listening to so much music and playing so much, that it still is the kind of the essence of my life. I'd say that what is most inspiring to me is when I find an artist or a musician who is completely uninhibited. You can almost tell that they're really genuinely expressing themselves, and they're taking some bold moves, and you can almost sense vulnerability in their music or their ideas.
Now I feel like I'm just now starting to find my voice. So when I come out on stage, whether it's the 300th show of a tour or the first, I feel like I'm always in search of the holy grail of myself, you know. The perfect performance is yet to come, you know. Those are years away, I think.
I like touring. I think touring is an essential part of being in this band. You know, live performance is going to be the reason that we can exist for a lot of years, you know. I was playing golf the other day. Golf's like my connection with things and life and people and earth and everything.
You can tell just about everything about a guy by the way he golfs.
Like, if you were to golf with me, you'd find out that I'm competitive, but I like to play by the rules. I want to win, but I want to win fairly. There's something in me that is fulfilled by writing. Of course I would love for others to be moved by it, but when I started to try to move me, that's when I started to write much better lyrics that really started to touch people. When I feel like there's no one that will ever know me, there you wanna show me. if just for a moment it makes them make a decision or do something better than they would have done it if not having heard the music. What a great reason for my life.
And I can always find my way.
Tonight we're pulling a prank.
I'm gonna go into a karaoke bar in Orlando, Florida.
So Pat got this fake mustache and a wig, and he's gonna go into a karaoke bar tonight and pose as someone else.
Yeah, damn it.
Nobody knows it's him except for me and some of our friends.
I was outside all stressed, and when they said, okay, the next guy is Billy Ray, and then Sean came out and goes, you're up, Billy Ray.
Billy Ray, please approach the stage. Billy Ray's coming up right now. Y'all ready to party?
You're done, man.
Get off your stage! You suck!
10 pounds too much to the naked eye. Don't take the bus to Cush Drive. Watermelon lipstick is way too much. You got a buttermilk smile and a thorny tongue. Come on, everybody, party! You say me and I will say it.
Hilarious, man. Was that guy for real or what?
No. That's actually the lead singer of the band Train.
No way.
No
really?
Way.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Are you kidding? That was hilarious. Are you kidding? Wait a minute. Jerry, come here. That was not the guy from Train. Oh my God.
Right on. Right on. That guy was hilarious.
I know. It was awesome.
Man. I've never done anything so difficult.
Radically bizarre.
It was so bizarre.
That dude was a f***ing freak.
Making it without you. Maybe I-
not your baba. Ask me ma to find it.
Well, today we're going to be in my hometown of Morris, Illinois. We're going to be visiting my parents. And my daughter is in town visiting with her mother's daughter.
You want to milk a cow?
I want to see it. I'm the cow. Look at the cow.
Just look out for this.
Daddy, help me.
Oh, it's okay, baby. Here.
What? I said it's going to poop.
That's okay.
Usually when I come home, a few neighbors will stop by the old picnic table out front of the house. So you never know what kind of trouble that's going to turn into.
I went to a concert here a few years ago in Chicago, and I can't remember which one it was. And of course, when you did your thing, I mean, I had tears in my eyes.
I wanted to look at my old concert shirts to see if I wanted to salvage any of them. Scorpions, REO Speedwagon, Journey,
Joan Jett.
This isn't my shirt. Here's the show Dad and I went to.
Yeah, we went to
the Hell's Bells. This is an official concert shirt from the Escape Tour. Picture of Paul Stanley. I think I made that. Here's my hand in 1970. Here's a drawing I did in 1979. Here's a logo I drew. That was my band in high school. Royal Star, that was just really, it started out, you know, on the back porch with those fake wooden guitars, you know?
We used to charge neighbor kids like 50 cents to come down and see us play, and we'd make popcorn for them and stuff.
That was our backdrop. I knew this was a mistake, bringing you here. our very first gig here was an after football game bash, and it was just crazy. But yeah, did he just yell out like something about train?
Yeah, he goes, yeah, train.
That's pretty cool.
Pouring rain, all the equipment is soaking wet.
It got rained out. It's like the World Series got rained out or something.
What are we gonna do today, right now? Play acoustically.
Guarantee.
Play
cool. I need a sign to let me know you're here.
Yeah, that's what I would do. You don't have to play that anywhere else.
I think people will dig this, man. I think it'll be a cool surprise.
All of these lines are being crossed over the atmosphere.
Obviously, the plans have changed. Show's gonna be acoustic. I'm not gonna be playing. So, yeah, it won't sound that great, I guess, but it'll be pretty cool. And here's Train. This is how we used to do it.
This is old school for us. We're gonna play a song now called All American Girl.
That's my favorite song of yours.
Is it?
Yes. I told him that
today. Is this gonna be like this? We're gonna have to push you back there.
Two.
Taxing, there's no such thing as satisfaction.
afternoon. My dad used to tell me I was lazy. I got dance moves like Patrick Swayze. I'm all over Turkey for the world's mayonnaise in a star next to the moon. Now I know I'm just here to amuse you, and I don't mean to abuse you, but if I could just use you one time, tell me what it's like to be the queen of it all, the Neiman Marcus of them all. Tell me what it's like to be the one and only All-American girl. The All-American girl. The All-Amazing Crazy Girl.
Really, the band has changed faces, you know, many times, you know, from the beginning.
I think that if you look back at the history of the band, you know, it started with me and Rob.
And then when I came in, you know, we kind of thought that we were going to be kind of like the Eagles, you know, where like everybody sang and, you know, everybody was featured.
And then bringing bass and drums in with Scott and Charlie, all of a sudden the dynamic changes. So you can see how the band is all of a sudden evolving into a rock band. And I think that as we evolve musically, that also means that you evolve emotionally and sometimes physically, and sometimes band members change because of that.
What we've kind of learned to do is be very open with outside influences. I don't think a band necessarily has to be like this sort of secluded club that nobody's welcome in.
We brought in two new musicians, a keyboard player and a guitar player.
Then we asked Johnny Colt, who was in a band called the Black Crows, to come and play bass with us, and it's incredible. The essence of Train is the one consistent thing that we have, you know. You want to constantly feel like there's room to improve, and I think that we've done that by letting these changes and these evolutions come naturally and not pushing them away and not forcing them to happen. So Train is Train and has been and will continue to be.